Hello and namaste. My name is Shireen Bala, and I'm the Director of Education at the Hindu American Foundation. As some of you know, springtime is typically when we celebrate Holi. However, many Holi celebrations have been postponed or canceled this year. But do not worry, we can celebrate this bright, colorful, and inspiring holiday at home. In today's presentation, I'm going to share with you why we celebrate Holi, what the significance is of this vibrant Hindu holiday, and how you can celebrate while in the comfort of your own home. So let's get started. Holi is a Hindu festival which celebrates the beginning of spring, which is the season of hope and new beginnings. This is a time for forgiveness, and people are encouraged to mend fences, pay off debts, renew broken relationships, and make new friends. The timing of Holi, like other Hindu festivals, is synchronized with the moon, which means that the actual dates vary from year to year. Holi typically falls on the full moon day between the end of February and the middle of March, according to the Hindu lunar calendar. This year, Holi began on March 9th, and in 2021, Holi will be on March 2nd. The first celebrations of Holi date back to ancient India. While the origins of Holi are Hindu, Holi is celebrated by both Hindus and non-Hindus around the world and is recognized as a national holiday in India. Depending on regional traditions and where you are in the world, Holi can be a two-day festival or an afternoon celebration. The first evening is known as Choti Holi, or Small Holi, and usually involves a symbolic bonfire as people gather around to sing and dance in the hopes of getting rid of bad thoughts and deeds from the previous year. On the second day, people of all ages will wear white to throw colored powder, gulal, or colored water, pani, at one another. In the evening, everyone gets together with their family and friends to enjoy festive foods, sweets, and companionship as they welcome the new year. Hindu temples are decorated with bright colors, and the deities are decorated with glittering jewels and clothing. Many Hindu temples and South Asian cultural centers hold Holi celebrations for their members, and festivities are often outside due to the use of colorful powders and water. However, many Hindu temples will also hold religious services inside their temple to honor the Hindu deities, Lord Krishna and Goddess Radha, as well as Lord Vishnu. Let's take a look at HAF's Holi Toolkit, which is an interactive guide to learn more about Holi in a fun and enjoyable way. You can access our toolkit from the new HAF website at hinduamerican.org. We've included a useful table of contents that explain what the activity is and how it can be used, as well as ways to celebrate at home, outdoors, in the classroom, and in the community. This nifty fact sheet provides the who, what, when, where, and how of Holi. But my favorite part is the date wheel that lets you know when Holi will be celebrated for the next 5 years. There are several stories as to why Holi is celebrated, and three of the more popular ones are narrated here. Regardless of why you celebrate Holi, the messages of love, goodness, and renewal are the same. We've included an educator's version of the stories and lesson plans that help students with pronunciation using the color vowel chart. I love seeing beautiful rangoli patterns on the floor or ground that use colored rice, dry flour, sand, or flower petals. We've included a couple here to have you print out and color in so you can have rangolis in your own home. Haikus are a form of Japanese poetry, which are structural as they must equate 17 syllables, with the first line having 5 syllables, the second having 7, and the third having 5. We've included a guide here to help you get started so you can practice writing your own haikus using the syllable structure. There are several places where you can practice your own haikus so you can come up with that perfect Holi haiku. Color plays a central role in Holi, and this activity uses the initialism Roy G. Biv, which describes the sequence of colors or hues that comprise a rainbow: red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. There are several great links on this page that explain additional information about color theory, the color wheel, a cool music video on primary colors, and a very interesting TED Talk about what it is like to hear color. This is my favorite page in the entire Holi Toolkit, as it explains the significant role colors have in Hinduism, as they are used for cultural celebrations, religious ceremonies, and signifying the essential qualities of deities. test your knowledge with our Holy Crossword Puzzle. Don't worry, we provide the answers at the end of the toolkit. For all of our learners, we have these handy printable cards that can be colored in and given to loved ones. We even have a place for a stamp, so you can mail them to your friends and family. Regardless of what is happening right now, it's important to stay positive and to find creative, healthy outlets. We hope that you find this toolkit a fun way to celebrate while staying safe. Thank you so much for celebrating Holi with us.